Does it depress you, Commissioner, to know just how alone you really are?
Michael Jackson's home, Neverland, is a 3,000-acre ranch 3 hours north of Los Angeles.
People are dying, Alfred. What would you have me do?
Endure, Master Wayne. Take it. They'll hate you for it, but that's the point of Batman. He can be the outcast. He can make the choice that no one else can make. The right choice.
As with most of his life, it has to be seen to be believed. Inspired by the children's fairy tale Peter Pan about the little boy who never grew up, it's a multi-million dollar man-made slice of make-believe.
The inspiration for Neverland, Peter Pan. Why is Peter Pan a figure of such interest and inspiration to you?
Because Peter Pan, to me, represents something that's very special in my heart. You know, he represents youth, childhood, never growing up, magic, flying, everything I think that children and wonderment and magic, what it's all about. And to me, I just have never, ever grown out of loving that or thinking that it's very special.
Do you identify with him?
Totally.
You don't want to grow up?
No, I am Peter Pan.
No, you're not. You're Michael Jackson.
I'm Peter Pan in my heart. I'm Peter Pan in my heart.
This is it. The climate is a problem for Jackson. He says the color-changing skin condition vitiligo has made him allergic to the sun. So, shielded by his umbrella, he took me to his most secret place.
I call it my giving tree because it inspires me. I love climbing trees in general, but this tree I love the most because I climb up high and I look down on its branches and it gives me... I just love it, so many ideas. I've written so many of my songs in this tree. I wrote Heal the World in this tree, Will You Be There, Black or White, Childhood.
Saying that you climb that tree.
Yeah.
How far do you climb up it?
All the way to that, see? All the way to that kind of spot up there, kind of like a deck where it's like a bed.
Do you want to climb it now?
Yeah.
Give me hold the umbrella.
Yeah.
You go and climb it, and let me, and when you've climbed it, let's see how inspiring it is.
Aren't you coming?
No way.
This is a big secret. I never show anybody my giving tree.
Okay, I'll try. I'm slightly worried about my shoes slipping.
Come on.
Is it safe?
Yeah, of course.
I'm frightened.
My inspiration.
I think I'm going to stop here.
You don't climb trees?
No, I do not.
You're missing out.
I'll leave you to it.
City's heart begins to bleed.
So how had this singing and dancing genius arrived in the surreal place that is his life today? I started to look for answers back at the beginning. He played me his first single, Big Boy, which was released when he was just 8. By then, Michael Jackson had already been performing for 3 years.
Do you remember when you first discovered that you had a special musical talent?
My mother caught me making my bed one day, and I was singing. And she said to my father that I could sing, and he didn't want to hear of it. You know, he said that Jermaine's the lead singer, not Michael. My mother said, Joe, you really should hear him sing. He can sing. He goes, no, Jermaine's the lead singer of the group, and that's it. She forced him to listen to me, and once he listened to me, from that moment on, I was the lead singer of the group. My entire childhood, I remember people always saying to me, he's a 42-year-old midget. At first I didn't understand, but what they meant was the way I, you know, moved on stage and the way I sang, like you say, the inflections or whatever.
Did somebody teach you to do that?
No, you can't teach that. You can't teach it. It has to come from inside. It's a gift, you know. Precisely going to Motown Studios to record. Right across the street from the studio was a park. And I could hear the roar of the, you know, the Little League team, and they were playing soccer and football and volleyball, and they were playing baseball.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I reach out my hand. I have faith in all you do.